Over 400 years ago in England, the king made rules about how people could pray. Everyone had to go to the king's churches.
I want you all to follow my rules and be members of my church.
No! We disagree! We want our own church!
So on September 6th, 1620, the Temple set sail to the New World on the Mayflower. The travelers were called pilgrims because they made a long journey to the end of the New World. They wanted to find a place where they could all have their own church. The pilgrim voyage carried 128 people instead of animals. The ship was not fun at all.
There isn't much room on the ship. I'm squish.
It smells bad in here.
I'm hungry and tired of eating the same food every day.
There aren't any bathrooms, and we can't even wash our clothes
yet.
The Mayflower sailed in good weather for the first month of their journey, but in October the winds changed, bad storms hit, and the rescue force decided to stay below the deck.
Wow, it's really cold and stormy out here.
I see land!
Yay!
On November 11, 1620, the pilgrims decided to anchor in a harbor at Cape Cod, Massachusetts. They named this place Plymouth.
No,
the pilgrims had no place to live in the fall of winter and autumn. They began building houses, but were not able to finish before the storm.
They worked as hard as they could, but they were hungry, cold, and weak. Many pilgrims got sick and many died.
In the spring, the pilgrims finished their homes and planned their gardens and things. The pilgrims soon met the Wampanoag Indians. They were very helpful.
Hal, we shall teach you how to farm.
Yes.
Donovan!
Oh!
Get over here!
In the fall of 1621, the pilgrims and the Wampanoags celebrated the harvest with a feast we call it First Thanksgiving.
From the water they shared fish, lobsters, clams, and oysters. From the gardens they had cucumbers, carrots, tuna, dragons, onions, and beans.
They were popcorn too. They had wild fruits for dessert. The children gave thanks for the new life they had been.